The first song I learned by heart was Forever's Not Enough by my coach Sarah Hedonim. My first idol in music, I guess it would have to be Michael Jackson, because the first time I saw him on TV, it was on TV, and I was a little boy, and I was like, oh, he can really move. I was really amazed and kind of like struck by, even though it was a music video on TV, I was kind of struck by like his power and his energy and the way he dances and sings, so yeah. I was 8 years old and I was a front act, and I remember just standing there and I was singing. I was only supposed to sing one song. So I was, after the first song, I was like, oh, yes, I'm finally done. I go off stage, and then the crowd was like, oh, more. And so the producer was like, okay, do you have one more song? And then my dad was like, oh yeah, he does. And I was like, oh no, they want me to sing again. So then I sang again, and I was just like this again. I didn't even move, even though I was like singing a high song. I was just like this. I didn't have any confidence then. I was like a pole. Recording my first album, I was actually sick the whole time. So I was really nervous on how it would sound when it was released. But thankfully my voice didn't sound too sick in the recording, and I don't think anyone knew I was sick because it sounded like my normal voice. So yeah, it was a lot of fun. And of course working with all the songwriters was another cool experience for me. The first person I had a duet with was my dad when I had a show in Canada. This was before The Voice. And we sang The Prayer. I guess it would be when I joined The Voice Kids, because that was a really big thing in my life and basically changed my life. And yeah, I guess I'd go back to that, because I don't know which part in The Voice, but I guess during those days, yeah.